Welcome back into the Sports Source. This segment brought to you by Medic Regional Blood Center. When you give life-saving blood, folks, you are giving back to your community. Nearly three dozen hospitals across East Tennessee count on Medic for emergencies, for surgeries, for blood, for plasma. You can save a neighbor's life, and it only takes you about 45 minutes. I've done it. You should do it. I'm glad I did it. MedicBlood.org. I ask you to do it. There's no greater gift you can give back to the East Tennessee community than the gift of life-saving blood. All right, got a hot read segment today. Usually we do these in football, but we got a hot read segment. Bob and Mike, that means two questions for each pairing, or one question for each pairing. Two questions total. Follow that?
Back first to me, the math nerd.
That's right. Bob and Mike, Missouri coach Barry Odom opened up on UT by name this week for recruiting his seniors right off his team, since the NCAA has hit them with probation and is allowing guys to leave. We'll pick up his complaint about teams right here. He says, everybody is going to have a bad day, Odom said, expressing his frustration with keeping his players from transferring. You combine that with somebody that, who'd we beat, 51-17 this year? Tennessee? Yeah, those guys. They are nonstop reaching out daily saying, hey, come here. The grass is not always greener somewhere else. All right, so not only does he open up on other teams, he specifically targets Jeremy Pruitt's staff and Tennessee. Does Barry Odom have a point regarding Tennessee or regarding the overall issue?
I don't know if I can answer that in 30 seconds or less. I'm going to say Tennessee has a right to recruit his players. Well, I would get into Missouri's penalty from the NCAA to me was NCAA overreach. That's not the question. But when you reach the point where Missouri is, hey, you did the wrong, then your guys have a chance to leave. I have no problem people going in there recruiting.
I understand his irritation with it, or any coach's irritation with somebody trying to come and get your players. But hello, this is the SEC. I don't blame Jeremy Pruitt or Will Muschamp or whoever tries to go get a good player. That's competition.
It happened at Ole Miss.
Yeah. I don't have a problem with Tennessee.
No.
With what they did here. Yeah. I do have a problem overall, though. I mean, I just think it's one thing if a player wants to put his name in a transfer portal and they come get it, but if it's all your seniors can go and then it's open season, everybody just calls. There was the story, and this was a Dennis Dodd story he talked about at Penn State. There were guys that would actually drive up their assistants from other schools and sit in the football facility parking lot.
I agree.
I agree.
It would be a better way to do it, but since it's not done that way, if Jeremy Pruitt says nope, not going to go recruit
with Pruitt.
Him,
yeah. Yeah, I think then, Odom has
and
a point.
And Alabama goes and gets two players and helps them. Okay, who is the wrong here?
Again, I have no problem with what Pruitt did.
But no, a portal would be a much better thing.
I think that's a pretty bad penalty to just but say that, open that, season, boys. Everybody call them.
That could decimate your program too.
Yeah, it's silly. I don't like that. That's if a kid wants to say, all right, I put my name in the portal, fine.
Chuck, that's our question down here. You got another question.
That's right. You guys button in down there. All right, now you two shut up.
Yeah, Jimmy, quit buttoning in.
Oh, all right, Jimmy and Chuck, Butch Jones was much maligned and Derek Dooley much maligned for trying to say that they had a year zero. Fans didn't like the year zero talk. Well, take a look at what Philip Fulmer said a week ago. He said, we continue to try and turn this big battleship in the way we want it to go. It's not going to happen all at once. We have to flip our roster in a couple, 3 years. This is really his first year. Did Jeremy Pruitt just get 2018 turned into a year zero?
How about it, Jimmy?
He might have about a hit by the athletic director, but in my opinion, no. I mean, it obviously it has to count. I don't remember anybody saying about Rick Barnes, well, his first year he had a losing record. That was a year zero. No, they all count. And I've seen some coaches come in. When Bruce Pearl came in, he had a great team his first year with all these players he inherited that weren't supposed to be very good. Now, this is year two. Yeah. I don't buy the ground zero.
I'm still trying to figure out high school football going to week zero. Yeah. I've never understood that one. But the start of the 2019 football season, it's Tennessee 2.0. You know, that's how that is. And you go through that, and you're going to be evaluated, I believe Bob said, midway through the third year. Pretty much, right?
Year zero, doesn't count. My feeling is this. There were a lot of fans that were upset and didn't want to give Dooley and Jones year zero. Better be consistent. That's all I'm saying. If you were the ones that said, heck no, And you can't be now saying, well, Pruitt needs time. You got to let it play the same for everybody. Either they all need a year zero or none of them need a year zero. You can't just pick and choose. But he's from Alabama. He'll get a year zero. Fulmer says, so he'll get a year zero.
His record's not zero and zero going into next year.
Nope. No, it's not.
And he could be fired at the end of year two then.
We'll see. All right. When we come back, what is the biggest concern? We got a good long segment coming up here. What is the biggest concern for Tennessee basketball at this point? You've lost one big game on national television. You just had a massive winning streak. Snap. But you got the strongest part of your schedule coming up. What is the biggest concern we have for Tennessee basketball? That's how we'll close it out. Come on back on the Sports Source.